Hi, in this video, we are going to discuss about a foot defect which I have covered with a free anterolateral thigh flap. And as a bonus, we are also going to basically see how to mark an anterolateral thigh flap. So let's get started. This is the defect of the left foot. The patient had a traumatic amputation of the first three toes. The fourth metatarsal was exposed and there were some exposed tarsal bones. This patient also happened to be a diabetic. So after seeing all the options, there are no other options really available, and we plan to do an anterolateral thigh flap. So in this slide, you can see the anterolateral thigh flap has been marked. The picture on the left side, you can see the anterolateral thigh flap has been marked. And here we are going to discuss how to mark an anterolateral thigh flap. You first mark the anterolateral, the anterior superior iliac spine. Now, the most important thing in marking an anterolateral thigh flap is that the marking has to be done with the patient in the supine position, lying on the operating table, and the toes should be pointing towards the roof. So after marking the anterior superior iliac spine, the second step is to mark the superolateral border of the patella. And after this has been done, then you draw a line from the anterior superior iliac spine to the superolateral border of the patella, which gives the position of the lateral intermuscular septum. That is the septum between the rectus femoris and the vastus lateralis. And this is in this septum, you have the descending branch of the lateral circumflex femoral artery. After marking the septum, you mark the midpoint of this line. And after marking the midpoint of this line, you draw a circle with 3 centimeter radius, and you draw 4 quadrants, and in the inferolateral quadrant you will find the most number of perforators. You will find mostly in the inferolateral quadrant. Here you can see I have done a Doppler and I have marked 3 perforators. One is in the inferolateral quadrant, the other one is in the superolateral quadrant, and the other one is quite proximal, maybe 7-8 centimeters proximal to it. And this is basically a perforator for the going to the tensor fasciae lata. After this has been done, I basically mark an exploratory incision which is 3 centimeters anterior to the septum. And this exploratory incision, once you take the exploratory incision, you identify the perforator, identify the lateral, identify the descending branch of the LCFA, then you can commit the rest of the flap. On the right side, you can see the photograph where the flap elevation has been done. You can see a perforator dissection has been done and no muscle is taken along with the perforator. In this slide, you can see the late post-operative results, 1 year post-operative. You can see the flap is well settled, the wounds have healed well. There are no areas of unstable scars. Here you can see the exploratory incision, which was used for identification of the anterior tibial artery and the great saphenous wheel. So basically, we had done 1 anastomosis of the artery, anterior tibial artery, and 2 venous anastomosis, 1 to the venae comitant and 2 to the great saphenous vein. Again, continuing with the late postoperative. Here you can see that the patient is able to walk. He has got an absolutely perfect gait. And because the flap is well settled, it is a thin flap and there are no residual wounds. The scar is well settled. He has got an absolutely perfect gait. Thank you for watching.